is the new WSGN, number one and getting bigger.
Which high school in Birmingham has the most school spirit?
The new WSGN is going to find out.
It's the most sensational contest ever to be broadcast on radio.
From the new WSGN, the world's most unusual radio station, comes
the WSGN High School Spirit Contest.
Each Birmingham High School will be competing for a tremendous prize.
The winning school will receive free from 610 a beautiful trophy and a free dance with a famous recording star.
The way to win is by petition.
The school which delivers the most petitions to our WSGN studios will win.
Keep listening for more wonderful details from the new WSGN
with your school all the way.
We're going to win and WSGN.
Outside from Birmingham's number one WSGN.
WSGN Action Central Sports.
Former football star Tony Borelli was shot and killed in Chicago Bear player. Joe Marconi was knocked unconscious early today in a brawl in a plush suburban bowling alley in Chicago. A policeman bully killed Borelli. Washington has taken a 7-3 halftime lead over Illinois in the Rose Bowl. In the Cotton Bowl, Texas 28, Navy 6. In the Sugar Bowl, Alabama down to Mississippi, 12-7 today. And in the Orange Bowl, Auburn fell to Nebraska. The score, Nebraska 13, Auburn 7. Elvinston, WSGN Sports Central.
Dynamic WSGN, the station that knows the score. 610.
Rodettes, 1963.
Oh, wrong speed tape. Come on, baby.
Tonight we met, I knew I needed you so. And if I had the chance, I'd never let you go. So while you say you love me, I'll make you so proud of me.
News, Birmingham News Center.
Hi there. I'm Bruno Bear.
Hello.
With a message I'd like to share.
Yeah, well, if we must.
It's smart to shop, Bruno. Ask anyone who knows. You'll find all the food you like best meets the test, and at Bruno's you save more.
Play, see, and save. Get your free see and save cards at Bruno's. Win thousands of top value stamps and try for the free family trip to the 1964 World's Fair. There's nothing to buy. Bruno's money-saving specials this week. Blackhawk bacon, the one-pound tray pack, 49 cents. Here's a real appetite pleaser. Delicious boneless chuck, so good and so economical, 59 cents a pound. Fresh, flavorful fryers whole, 25 cents a pound. At Bruno's, you save more than 64. And hey, be sure to get the 10-pound bag of Gut Shaw or Domino Sugar, 99 cents. Limit one with a $5 order at Bruno's now.
The best foods and meats are right there. We repeat, you save more at Bruno's store.
Yeah, save money at Bruno's, and be sure to play See and Save now.
What is See and Save? All right, that's what we'll play, though. Bon-dee-dong, ding-dong. It's 32 degrees outside in Birmingham, Alabama. And this is the new WSTN number one. Oh, it's a pretty song. All day long. Play the name that way because I can't pronounce it.
La, 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 la.
I can too. Emilio Pericoli.
Ring-a-ding, ring-a-ding, ring-a-ding-a-doo.
guys. We'll grab her home, hang around.
Dropped to the freezing mark in Birmingham, and North Alabama roads have begun icing over, causing very hazardous driving conditions. Some roads are closed. In news, that's the big story. At the desk in Action Central, this is Elvin Stanton. December snowfall on record, with records dating back to 1895. Ensley, a woman believed to be in her mid-40s, burned to death in her home in Ensley today to become the city's first fire death of the new year. The victim was identified as Mrs. Ruby Woodall of 3014 Avenue C in Ensley. The woman lived alone in her home. The cause of the blaze was not immediately determined. Birmingham, veteran city detective William M. Pryor died this afternoon of an apparent heart attack. Pryor, who had resided at 635 45th Street North, had been with the police department for some 26 years. He was dead on arrival at a local hospital. Johnson City, Texas. President Johnson disclosed today that he's determined to wage an unrelenting peace offensive in 1964. Mr. Johnson sent a New Year's greeting to Russian Premier Khrushchev, telling the Soviet leader that it's time to stop talking and start working for peace. Associates close to the president said the chief executive will seek new breakthroughs to improve relations with Russia, but that he aims to keep and improve U.S. preparedness. Across the nation, a snow and ice storm pushed up the Appalachians and the Atlantic seaboard today, causing hazardous driving warnings to be hoisted in 23 eastern states. The storm extended from Mississippi, where 18 inches of snow fell, to northern Maine. Washington, a Republican congressman, began the new year with a blast at President Johnson for pressure applied during the recent foreign aid bill debates. Representative H.R. Gross of Iowa accused Mr. Johnson of tough and ruthless arm-twisting to get the measure passed. Monticello, New York. A 24-year-old Army private has been charged with first-degree murder of a double axe slaying in Smallwood, New York. Police said Frank Scarmuzzo was apparently looting the home of his former fiancée when the family arrived unexpectedly. Police charged that Scarmuzzo killed the girl's father and a house guest and then seriously wounded his former fiancée. Pasadena, California. The annual Tournament of Roses parade has lived up to all of its expectations. 1.5